Welcome back. Well, it's time to welcome our next guest into the studio, Mark Hooper from Visit Shropshire. Mark, welcome to the show.
Ah, good, thank you.
Now, you've had a busy year at Visit Shropshire.
Yeah, it's been another manic year once again. Our first normal year, I'd say, as well, after we launched 3 years ago. So we've had 2 years of COVID and adapting to different things happening every other month. So this year's been our first real year we can act as a proper tourism association for the destination.
And what a difference has that made to you then?
It's been great to finally get and do some of the work that we really wanted to do, especially on the marketing side of things. Obviously throughout COVID it was always a bit hesitant about how much you did, how far in advance you planned, but this year has allowed us to actually create some proper strategies for the destination and follow them through without having to adapt halfway through a year really.
So for those that don't know, just remind us, what is Visit Shropshire?
So Visit Shropshire is the destination management organisation for the county. So we're a membership organisation that any tourism business or hospitality business or supplier can join as a member. And we're there to support the growth of the industry as a destination, but also those individual businesses as well. And that's predominantly through business support, through marketing initiatives. And that sometimes, as I said, it can be for the destination or can be right down to the individual business themselves.
So how far and wide are you promoting Shropshire then?
Well, we got as far as Japan this year. We did a Japanese travel networking event online. We'll say I didn't fly out to Japan. But we've done, we do quite a lot of initiatives with Visit Britain, which are international trade events, quite often where we'll go online and sell the destination to them. So for example, the Japanese Travel Mart, what it was that was always about marketing to groups and coaches that were flying into places like Heathrow, Manchester, and how can Shropshire get on that circular route, such as York and Bath and London. And I'm pleased to say that from off the back of that, we've definitely got some groups that are coming down, and I know they're going to Seven Valley Railway, and they're probably more likely to go to different destinations across the county as well.
You say that, I mean, people think of Shropshire, and the one name that always gets mentioned is Ironbridge, isn't it? But there are so many other destinations to see and visit.
Yeah, there is. What we often find is when we do the international side of things, we always say, what do you know about Shropshire? To start off with, have you ever heard of Shropshire? Where are we? And usually the answers are Ironbridge for a World Heritage Site, Ludlow for its food, and Shrewsbury for its flowers. And that's what's predominantly known across the world about Shropshire. But what we then find is that people will come here and explore all different areas of the county. There's one reason for that is that we don't have a city. So quite often if you have a city, people will go to the city, such as Bath, and stay within the city. But in Shropshire, being one of the biggest inland counties without a city, means that when people come here, they usually, a high amount of them, will travel around the county to all sorts of different places, like Oswestry, Whitchurch, Bridge North, and just some of those favourite places for
people. So in terms of money then, Mark, I guess that's better because it then spreads that tourism cash coming into the county, across the county.
Yeah, exactly. And for the economic growth side of things, it allows not everything to go into one honeypot destination. You know, during COVID, that was always quite good as well because you were spreading people apart instead of having honeypot locations, although we did still have that in places like Ironbridge. That was one of the things we had to do, was figure out how to manage those visitor numbers to make sure that everything was compliant. But yeah, it's great. People then travel around the county and discover places that they've never discovered before. And things spread, you know how social media works. So quite often Shropshire's not a bad place for taking a photograph, so it just spreads really.
And have you got a good geographical spread of people that are engaging with you? Have you got all corners of the county covered?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, we deal with members as far down as Cleobury Mortimer, as far up as Whitchurch. We've just welcomed a complete business group from Whitchurch, actually, that has been led by one business in the town centre who got a whole group of businesses together to join as a big group membership of the association. And there are all sorts of businesses. Some are retail, some are restaurants, some are brand new, some have been there 20, 30 years in the town. But it just shows a collective of businesses that have got together on such a thriving high street and want to reach the tourist crowd out there.
Is that
really
something you'd like to see more of then? As you say, I know that the businesses got together in Whitchurch, so maybe if someone did the same similarly in Ludlow or Oswestry Street, is that going to help?
Yeah, definitely. Something that's really good about Shropshire is how we all work together. And whether that's in towns themselves through retailers working together next door to each other, or as neighbouring towns we quite often find as well working together to benefit from each other. For example, I was in Broseley a few months ago, and how they work, because they can benefit hugely from that international pull of Ironbridge, but it's a beautiful destination just over the hill in Broseley there. So it's how they work together. But yeah, it's great. And we're always open to conversations with destinations about speaking to high streets, especially as well, because that's all part of the visitor experience.
And in terms of local visitors, where are they coming from if they're in the UK already, for example?
We have quite a big geographical split across, and there's no one set place. We have some... our top 10 places include number 8, which is actually New York, is our 8th really? Most visited place on our website of people who view us. Our third highest international audience is actually the Seychelles, which is, you know, you wouldn't guess this. It's predominantly to do with the TV show Brother Cadfael that's in the Seychelles, and people wonder where it is, but it's still quite prominent on TV over there. So in regards to in Britain, where do people come from? We obviously have that 2-hour radius that's quite easy for our urban areas such as Birmingham, Liverpool, Manchester. But we get a huge number of people that fly into the county, into London and then out. And that's why we've got a partnership with West Midlands Trains as well, because it's always been a challenge for counties across the country to get people out of the M25. And so working with a transport provider, that's what we've aimed to do. I know today's not a very good one because they're probably on strike again, but in a normal world, it's actually worked very well. And we've even just launched the brand new trains from Birmingham to Shrewsbury as well.
And you mentioned Brother Cadfael and the power that has in the Seychelles. That brings you on nicely to the other element of what you've been involved in this year, Film Shropshire, as well, which fits in perfectly, doesn't it? This is brand new, isn't it? So tell us
about it. Brand new. So, 12 months old now, believe it or not. It's been a quick year, but it's been a really exciting year for film and TV in Shropshire. So, as you're probably aware, I think we've covered things before with Great Expectations, which was our biggest production, which happened in May. We've also had The Apprentice that's been filmed here. We've had Hunted. We've had... Susan Kalman's Grand Day Out that was recently on Channel 4, and only yesterday we were in touch with another Stephen Knight production about coming back to Shrewsbury within the next couple of months. You can never promise anything, because sometimes they go through, sometimes they don't. It's exactly what the location manager's looking for, but we're really on the map. And only last week I was down in London at Focus, which is the leading trade event for the industry, and it was really warmly welcomed, and it was great that they were looking forward to meeting a new destination for filming that has maybe not really been on the screens before.
So is this you having to pitch Shropshire as a location, or is this you answering queries from location managers that have already decided they want to come here?
Yeah, it's a little bit of both, really. And that's something we've learned as we've gone along, is in regards to destination, it's what you've got. You can't create something you haven't got. So we have had plenty of location managers contact us about various different buildings they'd like, and we simply don't have them, and you can't make them, and that's it. And sometimes it's quite disappointing to think it's a feature-length film, and you think that's brilliant, absolutely fantastic, but if you don't have it, you don't have it. So you've got to work with what you work with. But what we do is we sell the destination to them, but not just the destination as locations, but also the logistics behind it. So we've recently had a production here where we've managed their accommodation, we've managed unit bases, we've managed catering, a huge amount to make sure that their experience in the county is as easy as possible as well. And not that we just have the location, but none of the infrastructure with it, but also to make sure that we don't cause a nuisance as well when we're filming. You know, shops still need to get deliveries to them. People still need to go about their daily lives, and not to shut roads down for weeks on end so that no one can get to them. So everything's got to be quite strategically managed in the whole process.
I mean, I always think it's amazing that more people don't experience and discover Shropshire, because they've got some, you know, just such fantastic places. You mentioned Broseley earlier, because Benthall Hall was used for Enola Holmes.
Yeah, Enola Holmes, that's right.
We've got a trailer of one of the latest Netflix productions, which brought Wonder Woman herself to Shropshire earlier this year, didn't it?
Yeah,
Gal Gadot was racing around RAF Cosford, wasn't she?
RAF Cosford, yeah, that's correct.
Have a look at this, see if you can spot any of Cosford in this.
You know what you signed up for. No friends. No relationships. What we do is too important.
Action! Heart of Stone is gonna be extremely epic. It's a super grounded, raw action thriller.
It has these characters that you really connect with and feel for.
It's target approaching.
Take it, I'm no longer compromised.
There's so much going on, and it's so big scale.
We really wanted to make sure we keep it realistic so people can feel the pain. Rachel Stone lives off the adrenaline. She's addicted to it.
Stone? Stone!
So there you go, that's Heart of Stone, coming to Netflix sometime next year. We don't know, probably April, May time. Looks pretty full on, but that reminds you, Mark, doesn't it, how it's not just the big screen, small screen have big budgets now as well, don't they?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. So we've had quite a good mix here between TV and film productions, and they can be quite different to work with. The TV's obviously a lot shorter, and it can be a lot more involving the public as well. If you think about Hunted and The Apprentice, you're dealing with actual public there and making sure that, one, things don't get out. Obviously with The Apprentice, it's no video footage out because you'd know who was in the process at the time and things like this. Whereas usually the film ones is completely closed off and quite a little bit easier to manage on the day. But yeah, it's been quite a good split for the county actually. And the as I mentioned, The Apprentice that's coming, that is going to be coming out in March, and that'll link really well because it's the tourism episode. It'll look really good in time for the tourism season before the spring and summer.
Creates a bit of a buzz as well, does it? We were actually filming, Carl, in the town centre when they were doing The Apprentice.
We were, yeah.
And I remember Hunted, as you say, about there was those helicopters going over Shrewsbury, and the amount of messages we had on Shropshire Live that morning, what's going on, there's all helicopters over, the amount of stories that come out of that, of what it could have possibly have been. But it's quite funny, and as you say, creates a buzz and great expectations when that was being filmed. That was quite interesting, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, it's been quite a learning curve about different things, such as the helicopters themselves. You know, there's a number of different places across the county that have no fly zones over them, including one was Shrewsbury Prison that still had one in place from when it was a prison.
Really?
And so there's various things that you learn along the way that usually common knowledge you would never know, really. We only learnt this week that actually any filming in Wales, they won't allow any smoking indoors in Wales, but you are allowed to do period drama smoking in a property in England, but not in Wales. And we've got a few places that are just on the border, that cropped up. So you do learn something every day about different rules and regulations around the industry.
I tell you one thing I'm sure you've learnt this week. I saw one of your social media posts go almost viral this week when you said, we've got a movie production which is looking for a particular kind of property. Has anybody got anything to match? You had a massive response.
Yeah, that's it. It's been an absolutely brilliant response from across the county. And it's opened so many different doors and ideas from people about different properties they have or different assets that they've got or people that they know. We put it out on Facebook. It was a period cottage that we're looking for with some quite distinct features. It's not got even a commission date as of yet, but they're still on the location lookout for the whole film. But we've had a great response. It went to tens of thousands of people in a number of hours, and the emails went berserk with pictures of cottages and fireplaces and oak beams, which are all absolutely beautiful properties, I must say. And we then send them to the location teams, and they filter through them and pick probably a handful that they'll then come and view. At that point, they'll then view them, and then it'll go down to even the art department and the producers come in. And it takes quite a process until it's whittled down to the last place. But we'll be doing this soon when we launch a new website, which is due for the end of January, beginning of February. And people will be able to list their own properties on there and manage their listings on the website on filmshropshire.co.uk. And so, again, we're hoping that all people that send over these properties feel free to list away on there.
It's all about presumably just producing a database so that a production feels that they can get all bases covered in one place, isn't it? Whether it's media people or stunt performers or set dressers, or they want to have a one-stop shop, don't they?
Yeah, exactly that. That's it. So it's about creating a directory of exactly what we have. So it's not too hard so that they don't have to keep asking and trying to filter, and we have to keep asking and trying to filter out what we've got as well. So that we've got one place that they can go, see what we've got and go, but we're probably still not going to cover the whole county even at that point. You know, the one yesterday with Stephen Knight, we're looking, there's one particular scene where we need a bridge, for example. So that then brings in people like Shropshire Council's highways teams that we'll have to pick that up with and see if things are possible. And you can't picture every single mile of road in Shropshire as the council will probably tell you, there's simply too many. But these questions keep coming through, and as the location managers speak, people start to know what's there. So we're looking forward to the new year when some of the things that have been filmed are coming out on the screen, and seeing what the response is like then.
Will we see you as an extra lurking anywhere in the background then?
You definitely won't do. I hope not. It's a mistake if you do. but no, I firmly stay out of the way on film days like that.
So is there anything that businesses who are watching this can help you with at the moment from this point of view?
Well, it's interesting, especially from the supplier side of things. We're keen to hear from any suppliers that feel that they would like to supply the industry, whether that's accommodation, catering, filming equipment, such as here today, and how would they, you know, what can they offer really? Because one of the biggest things is what film crews don't want to do is actually ship loads of things around the country all the time. And for us, it's always been about using local suppliers. You know, one thing that we're really keen to do, and we've started conversations with the college groups about how we can get works experience for college students on set, to see that you can actually be on, for example, a Stephen Knight production in your hometown. And you know, there's not many towns around the country that could actually say that. And so we're really keen about keeping things within the county and using that local supplier network.
Lots to do for the new year then, sounds exciting.
It does.
Lots to do, yeah, both Visit Shropshire and Film Shropshire. It's going to be a busy year ahead, but exciting really. So yeah, really looking forward to it.
Fantastic, thank you for joining us, Mark.
Yeah, thanks for coming in, great to see you. We're going to take another short break now. In a couple of minutes though, we've got a very special guest in our 90 Seconds with Hot Seat for this show.